Nearly one half of the country, from the Pacific coast to the Great Plains and the upper Midwest, is experiencing moderate to exceptional drought conditions. It's expected to get worse through the summer. But as William Brangham reports, it's the western states in particular that are taking the hardest hit.
Across the American West, there simply isn't enough water to go around, and the full heat of summer is just getting started. From the Rio Grande to the Rocky Mountains, a mega drought is underway. It's shaping up to be the worst water crisis in generations. The darker the red, the worse it is. Reservoirs that store water for millions are below normal and are projected to hit historic lows soon. This month, California's governor, Democrat Gavin Newsom, expanded drought state of emergencies to 41 of his state's 58 counties, affecting one-third of the state.
Let me just say, state unequivocally, guys, it's really bad.
In Utah, Republican Governor Spencer Cox declared a statewide drought emergency and has asked all residents to conserve water. Lake Mead, which is created by the Hoover Dam, is the largest reservoir in America, and it's getting so low, it could trigger a first-ever federal shortage declaration, which could limit water for millions. For those who've been studying climate change in the West, this has been brewing for years.
Since the year 2000, the Western United States and Northern Mexico has been in near perpetual drought.
Park Williams is a climate scientist at UCLA. By studying ancient tree rings, he's able to compare today's climate and drought conditions to those of the past.
While there have been droughts that were longer than this one in the past, you've got to go back hundreds of years to find one. This drought, which is now 22 years old, is just as severe as the driest 22-year periods in any of those historic mega droughts.
And this one's not over, as far as we can tell.
No, this drought is far from over. 2021 is shaping up to potentially be the driest of all of the drought years in the last century, and definitely one of the driest of the last millennium.
This intense dryness is endangering fisheries and wildlife, while farmers across the West are facing crop failures and cattle losses.
When you're talking about compounding multiple years of drought, it becomes very, very difficult.
Kevin Richards is a fourth-generation farmer in central Oregon.
If you don't have the water to plant a new crop, then you're starting off one step behind next year. So even if the drought were to recover, if we don't have new crops in the ground that need planted in the fall, then it's really going to take an entire 12 more months to recover.
And there is, unfortunately, no relief in sight. Much of this year's winter snowpack was well below normal. For example, in California, where snowmelt delivers roughly three-quarters of the state's water, snow cover is the lowest it's been in the 21 years that NASA satellites have been monitoring it. All of this parched land increases the likelihood of another deadly, destructive, and extended fire season. California has already seen 900 additional wildfires this season, compared to this point in 2020, which itself was a record year. And this is a region-wide concern. From last spring to this winter, Arizona, New Mexico, Nevada, and Utah each had their driest stretch in 126 years.
For the farmers that grow hay, if they do have hay, they're in a good position because the price is high.
Dustin Cox is a farmer and cattle rancher in Utah.
We're getting into the point of, okay, do you feed cows $250 a ton hay, or do you sell the cows? If you sell the cows, you're not going to get very much right now, because if all the ranchers sell cows, then there's a big supply of cattle. There's not a big demand because no one in the West, it's not like it's just regional, right? It's all over the West.
Drought conditions are also causing problems for Native American communities, like the Yurok tribe, which lives along the Klamath River in Northern California.
Drought puts our natural resources and way of life at risk.
At a virtual hearing this week, Yurok Representative Amy Cordalis told Congress that drought, as well as restrictions on water flows by the government, had harmed the salmon, which are central to her tribe's traditions and economy.
Historically, the Klamath River was the third largest salmon-producing river on the West Coast. Tragically, it's estimated only 2 to 5% of the salmon runs remain today, and we have lost millions of dollars as a result.
And the impact of this drought could ripple out to consumers nationwide. A huge percentage of the nation's fruits and vegetables, nuts and beef come out of this increasingly arid West.
It's going to take more good luck to pull ourselves out of this drought and less bad luck to fall back into the drought. The long-term normal is changing in Western North America toward a drying one.
For the PBS NewsHour, I'm William Brangham.